Hi. The telescope offered an opportunity for anyone who built one or could gain access to one in some way to make discoveries, because anytime a better telescope could be built, there were more things to be found. And this was true then, some 65 years after Galileo's observations, for Giovanni Cassini, who was an Italian astronomer who went to France and became a French citizen and developed the observatory in Paris. And several generations of his family continued to operate that observatory for many years. And he discovered the rings of Saturn, not the rings themselves, but the structure of the rings. He found that there was a major gap called Cassini's division. And he was the first person to theorize that the rings themselves were made of very small objects orbiting around Saturn. So we could think of these even as moonlets orbiting around Saturn. And we know from close-up observations by spacecraft this is indeed the case. He also discovered four satellites of Saturn: Iapetus, Rhea, Tethys, and Dione. And and so this made quite a few moons that have now been discovered in the solar system, our own moon, and Jupiter's five more moons of Saturn, making 10 total moons in the solar system. So, a big thing, though, was on the horizon for science, and that is a few years later, in 1686, Isaac Newton published Principia, and it described the planet's motions by a force of gravity, which unified the idea of gravity here on Earth that had been investigated by Galileo, for instance, that the acceleration of an object near the surface of the Earth is constant, and so the velocity will increase until the object hits the ground. And Newton thought about the moon in the same way, as affected by gravity and effectively falling towards the Earth while going fast enough in orbit so as not to fall to the Earth, but always continually falling towards the Earth. And Newton described this in this book that is considered one of the most important books in science of all time. Edmund Halley urged Newton to publish this, paid it for the publication of Principia, and Edmund Halley was famous for the comet that bears his name, that he saw that records show that in 1531, 1607, and 1682, a comet with the same kind of cycle period would come again after 76 years, because that was the cycle that he was seeing in terms of the length of time between appearances of this comet. That Halley made the prediction based on the idea that this comet was orbiting in an elliptical orbit around the sun, and And one of the things that Isaac Newton could do with his law of gravity was show that Kepler's laws were a consequence of gravity. And so Kepler's laws did a great job of explaining how the objects in the solar system orbited the sun and how moons orbited planets, for instance, but they did not give a reason why. What was an underlying physical cause of this? And so Newton explained that in terms of gravity, which is Newton's law of universal gravitation, is a force acting between every pair of particles in the universe. So if I consider one object may be the sun, another object may be the earth, there is this force between them that is equal on each object. So the force pulling the earth towards the sun and the force pulling the sun towards the earth are equal forces and equal to this constant of gravitation, the universal constant of gravitation, times the product of the two masses times the distance between them squared. And you can see that the reason why the forces are the same is that it doesn't matter if I switch mass one and mass two, the distance between them is the same, the product would be the same, and so the force would be the same. So it's a mutual force between two objects, and that all of the objects in the solar system have this mutual attractive force. And what makes Kepler's laws work is the fact that the sun is so much more massive than other objects in the solar system. The other objects are orbiting around the sun, and they can be thought of as a two-body problem, with the sun as the main mass and each of the planets as separate mass, with only small effects caused by forces between other objects, say the force between Earth and Mercury would be very small in comparison to the force between Mercury and the Sun, or Mercury, the Venus and the Sun, or Earth and the Sun, or Jupiter and the Sun. So this really provides a different way of looking at how gravity drives the motions of the planets, explains Kepler's laws, and provides a description of how gravity works on all scales. And this was even shown by an experiment by Cavendish with small spheres located in a laboratory, showing that they were actually also pulled together by force of gravity. So this is a universal law of gravitation, a force between all pairs, every pair of objects in the universe.